Mankind's attitude to gold is odd. All 118 elements of the periodic table? Gold is the one we humans have always tended to choose to use as currency. Why? Why not platinum or titanium? Or helium, say? Or maybe rhodium? Elements like gases and liquids are not practical to use for currency. Alkaline metals in Earth's well. Try dropping magnesium in water and see what happens. Not so good. Obviously, we can't use gases and liquids as currency. Lead and copper were used as coins in ancient China, but they quickly corroded. And leads are highly toxic. So why is it gold? How gold can preserve society's stability? And what would happen if gold loses its value? In fact, gold has been inextricably linked to human civilization since 6000 BC, at least. Gold has been used for facilitating trade and economic growth, and acting as a store of value for accumulated wealth. Unlike many other metals, gold is not a rare metal, but it is difficult to find and extract the same in large quantities with pre-industrial technology. The high cost of production associated with it makes the price rise more. So, how does gold impact the economy? Look at the currency market. Gold prices tend to reflect changes in the value of the US dollar compared to other foreign currencies. When the dollar is strong, it means that even if gold prices stay flat in dollar terms, gold will be more expensive in foreign countries whose currencies have declined in value. If gold rises, currency drops. It's the other way around. Also, it is associated with economy strength. When the economy weakens, demand for stocks and other financial assets slackens, and that drives more money toward what are perceived to be more stable investments, such as cash and gold. In exchange values, gold gives certainty in international trade by providing a fixed pattern of exchange rate. During World War I, because war resources were hardly convertible to paper money, and currencies were not interchangeable, countries have established a standard that allows to buy things from each other with gold. The standard has been effective since then. And that's why people who once have lived under an insecure environment will have greater preference for gold, because they need more sense of security. In society, gold limits the power of governments or banks to cause price inflation by excessive issue of paper currency. Under a gold standard, new money could only be printed if a corresponding amount of gold were available to back the currency. As gold is scarcity in nature, the supply of gold will not increase too quickly. And by linking gold and money together, the supply of money in the market will stay relatively stable. On the other hand, if the supply of money rises too fast, people will exchange money for gold in the purpose of preserving wealth. If this goes on too long, the treasury will eventually run out of gold, which may lead to the bankruptcy of a country. That's why the gold standard can restrict governments from keep printing money, which in turn limits the inflation rate of a country. Gold is a way of going long on fear, Warren Buffett once said. He also explained that if people become more afraid, you make money. If they become less afraid, you lose money. But the gold itself doesn't produce anything. Investors' fear levels are particularly high right now, as the coronavirus pandemic turned a global health crisis into an economic one. And it's uncertain when the world will recover from either of these crises, not to mention about the US-China trade war. It is in such times of uncertainty that gold is touted as a safe haven for those looking for shelter from more traditionally volatile investments, like stocks. But imagine, what if gold is losing its value? First thing first, the world will collapse. Economy will not be stable anymore. But investors shouldn't panic over a drastic drop in gold prices. Because investor will go from gold to silver instead. Subscribe our channel. Like, share, and comment below for letting us know more about your thought.